each one following the other, namely Passion Sunday, His suffering and death, Easter Sunday, His resurrection, and Divine Mercy Sunday, His mercy and compassion. During the first Holy Week, when Jesus entered triumphantly to the city of Jerusalem, a great multitude of people met him on his way with palm branches in their hands, singing songs of praise, and acclaim him as their beloved, wonderful King. 5 days later, their solemn acclamation turned into hateful, sorrowful voice. Now they were out shouting harshly, "Crucify him! Crucify him!" He died hanging on the cross with two thieves, Demas and Estas. Demas looked at Jesus with repentance in the heart and prayed, "Lord, remember me in your kingdom." Demas was saved, and all repentant sinners, you and I, and all future children of God. But to those who are slow to change this way of life, Christ remained patient and waits for them to repent. Jesus is merciful and compassionate. His mercy is not measured. It is unlimited. So His forgiveness is unlimited. However great sinners you are, all of us together. On Easter Sunday, Jesus resurrected from His death. He appeared to the holy women and the apostles, except Thomas, who was not around with the rest. The apostles told Thomas that Jesus was alive again, that they had seen Him with their own eyes and heard Him talk with their own ears. Thomas was unwilling to accept their testimony. He said, "I'll never believe it without putting my finger in the nail marks and my hand into His side." Thomas was taking no chances after all what had happened to Jesus on Calvary. He was afraid to take his faith at risk to another disappointment. It's all experience, all of us. If we fail in one thing, we don't like to repeat the same thing, because otherwise it will be the same thing. We will be disappointed. We will never realize what we want to have in life. But Jesus appeared a second time and hovered over him, visual proof of His resurrection. Jesus said to doubting Thomas, "You became a believer because you saw me. Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." He did not rebuke Thomas because his faith needed visual seeing. What Jesus means to say is that Christian faith at its best means taking a chance. How many of us are taking chances with our faith in God? Believing in that which ought to be, even though we cannot prove it, that's faith. Believing in something which we cannot prove, But we believe because of God's will and knowledge given us every time. Christ approached the way had nothing to do with safety and security. He based his faith on knowing and doing the will of God. He is committed for that purpose and bent his life on love, even his death on the cross, because of his faith for all of us that one day we will return to him, repented, so that his purpose on earth to bring us all into heaven will not be in vain. How about us? He never discourages people from seeking truth, expressing doubts, or admitting they did not know. We are Christ's students who would want to learn. We must not limit our faith to the size of our understanding, because we don't understand very much. Christ offers us encouragement as seekers of truth. And so, there is joy in building our lives on things that ought to be believed, even though we have never seen them with our eyes or touched them with our hands. We are sometimes like Thomas, who wait for proof to avoid the pain of failure. We don't like to fail, so we don't like to go on adventure, trip of finding out the truth. Why you are here on earth, why you want to be loved, why you want to get married, and why you want to be who you are right now. My friends, don't spend your life playing it safe. Bet on your life, bet your life on those things that you have never seen and will never see. Believe and work for those things that ought to be. All of us together, pray with me and follow me. Oh, faith in the heart. All faith in the heart leads to justification.
Leads to justification.
Confession on the lips.
Confession on the lips.
To salvation.
To salvation.
Now, God bless you all. We are all saved if we build our life on the future with faith in God. Thank you, and God bless you.